Hello students, today we are going to learn a topic named angles in name. Yes, names do have angle, but when they are represent in straight lines. Okay, if you have given name like this, Sukhman. Okay, so this name is created using the curves. So if name is given like this, you have to write this name using straight lines. In most of the cases, the name will be given like this. But if in some question a name is given like this, you have to write the name using straight lines. Simple. So let's see how these names have angles. So in our case, the name is Sukhman. The name starts with the letter S. So in such a type, we have to first find how many right angles are there in this name. Then we have to find how many angles are more than 90 degrees. That is more than right angle. Okay, right angle is nothing but 90 degrees. More than 90 degree means which angle? More than 90 degree is nothing but obtuse angle. And finally we have number of angles less than 90 degree. Less than 90 degree will be acute angle. Am I clear? We have already studied what is right angle, what is obtuse angle, and what is acute angle. So just we have to find this angle in this given name. Let's see, letter S contain which angles. So always remember, we have to first find right angles. So let's start with the letter S. In S, how many right angles are there? That is, how many angles are making 90 degree? Let's see. So if I consider this angle, then this angle is 90 degree. After that, this angle is 90 degree. After that, this angle is also 90 degree. And finally, we have this angle is also 90 degree. So in S, we have 4 right angles. After that, in U, we have this right angle and this right angle. Now you will say, sir, how do you know this is right angle? So we have already studied the angles which are in the shape of L. L like this, L like this, then L like this, L like this. Any L shape make 90 degree. So S has 4 right angle, U has 2 right angle. Does K have any right angle? No. Let's go to H, the next alphabet. It has 1 right angle, 2nd right angle, 3rd right angle, 4th right angle. So H has how many right angle? 4 right angle. After that we have M. Does M have any right angle? No. Does A have any right angle? No. Now finally, the letter N. Do N have any right angle? No. So let's count total number of right angle in the given name. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Okay? So total number of right angle in the given name is 10. Okay? Are you clear with that? How to find right angle in given number? Let's see. How many number of angles are more than right angle? That is more than 90 degree. The angles which are more than 90 degree are known as obtuse angle. So let's see. How many angles are more than 90 degree? So S don't have any more than 90 degree angle. U don't have any more than 90 degree angle. Here in this case, this is not more than 90. This is also not more than 90. But this is more than 90. So K has 1 more than 90 degree Celsius. Here this M is also not more than 90, not more than 90, not more than 90. Do A have more than 90 degrees Celsius, that is obtuse angle? Yes, they have this angle and this angle, which are same, more than 90 degree. Does N have any right, any obtuse angle? No. So total how many obtuse angle? 1, 2 and 3. So total number of obtuse angle which are more than 90 degree are only 3. And now finally, the acute angle. Acute angle are which angle? The angles which are less than 90 degree. Let's see how many angles are less than 90 in this given name. So this is the 1, this is 2. Does H have? No. M have 1, 2, 3. 3 acute angle. A have this 1, this 2 and this 3. And finally we have letter N, which has 1 and 2. So let's count total number of acute angle. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 and 10. So the total number of acute angles are 10. So students, are you clear with the angles in name? How to find angles in any given name? You might have some question based on this in assignment as well as in your coming unit test. So prepare these types of question very carefully. And if you are not understanding, repeat, rewatch the video. Then still if you are not understanding, message me or call me. Okay? Okay students, so the next topic is angles and time. Based on this topic, you might have question like that. Okay, write the time and write the angle made by hands of the clock. Okay? So you might have question like, write the time for a given clock and write the angles which are made by these hands of the clock. Okay, so let's see the first example. Here, the hour hand is at 3 and the minute hand is at 12. So the time is 3 o'clock. Now we have written the time. So now let's see what angle does it make. Do you see the shape of this time is? Yes, it is L type. So any angle made by L shape is right angle. Exactly 90 degree angle made by hands of clock. Is it clear? This minute hand and hour hand, distance between these two hands or the turn between these two hands are the angle, and which is 90 degree. Is it clear? Let's take another example. Here the minute hand is at 8 and hour hand is at 3. So the time is 3:40. Is it clear? Now let's see what angle made by these two hands of the clock, or the distance between these two hands. So as you can see, this distance is more than 90. So more than 90 means which angle? Obtuse angle. Obtuse angle or angle more than 90 degree. Here you can write it is right angle. Is it clear, students? Let's take a last example. In the last example, as you can see, the hour hand is at 1. So we have to write 1 and the minute and is at 3, that is 15 minutes. So the time is 1:15. Now see, let's see the angle. The angle is this. The distance between these two hands is this. So as you can see, the distance is less than 90. So the last angle is, which is less than 90, is a acute angle. That is less than 90. Now is it clear? You might ask that draw the acute angle with the hands of clock. So the acute angle is less than 90. So you have to draw like this. You have to draw hands like this. So the angle made by two hands will be less than 90 degree. So I hope you are clear with the angles and time. Okay. The next important topic is changing shape. As you can see, the square, which has four right angles, each angle is of 90 degree. We have to see if we apply any pressure on any of the vertexes. As you can see, these four dots represents vertex of the square. If we apply pressure on any one of the vertex, does it change the angle of the square? Let's see. If we apply pressure on this vertex, yes, it does change the angles, except this all three angles where we have applied the pressure has been changed. The angle is decreased. Am I right? Are you clear with that? We will see the change in angles using another example. As you all are familiar with this shape, the shape which has five sides is nothing but pentagon. Pentagon has five different angles. As you can see, the value of these angles are given. These angles are made by the sides of pentagon. Is it clear, students? Now we have to see if we apply pressure on any one of the vertexes. As you can see, these five dots represent vertexes. So if we apply pressure on any one of the vertex, does it change the angle of the pentagon? Let's see. If we apply pressure on the top vertex, as you can see here, all the angles related to that vertex changes. So from this we can conclude that if we apply pressure on any one of the vertexes of particular shape, it does change the angle. Is it clear, students? Very good. Now we will see the last topic of the chapter, that is why triangles are used in construction of a structure like bridges and towers. As you can see in the picture, this mighty construction has used many triangle shape in the construction. The triangles are clearly visible in the construction. Let's take another example. If we take an example of bridge, as you can see, the triangles in the bridge are clearly visible. Almost all the bridge uses this triangular shape for their construction. So why would they use triangle shape? Let's take another example of a triangle used in a construction, that is tower. As you can see, this electric tower mostly use the triangle for their construction. The triangles are clearly visible. So the reason for using triangles in construction or in towers is that
When we apply pressure to triangle, the shape and the angles of triangle do not change easily. Is it clear? The triangle shape and angles do not change easily. Thank you.